The useful properties of materials really depend on how you combine their component atoms and molecules. The right combination can give you remarkable properties, enabling battery electrodes with better performance, new materials to capture and store solar energy, or new materials for applications in healthcare and computing. Similarly, by combining together, the University of Washington and Pacific Northwest National Lab can join their expertise in material science to have a greater impact on the world. That's why we've created the Northwest Institute for Materials Physics, Chemistry, and Technology, or Northwest Impact. By working together, we can enable new research teams to have an impact greater than that from their individual components.
Our goal is to move beyond the traditional focus in material science of the relationship between the structure of material and how it functions, that is, where the atoms need to be placed in order to get a certain set of properties, to a true science of making materials, which is about understanding how to get the atoms where they need to go.
Well, my own research program in computational molecular science, I've been able to bring that out here to PNNL and collaborate with a number of researchers who are in the wet lab doing experiments related to synthesis, characterization, and analysis of new materials. And together, we're able to make new strides that we wouldn't be able to do individually.
In nature, there are examples of amazing biomaterials like bone, spider silk, abalone shell, and up till now, humans haven't really understood how to make these types of materials. And here at the Institute for Protein Design, we're learning the fundamental principles for designing new biological materials and actually making completely new types of materials. The partnership with PNNL is really critical, both because PNNL has amazing instrumentation. It's very difficult to do the experiments to characterize the formation of these materials. And just as importantly, they have the expertise.
To understand and predict the materials that were just described, we're going to combine our unique computational and experimental efforts. The challenge for theorists is to incorporate the right amount of microscopic detail so that we can explain the observed emergent macroscopic phenomena. The point is to have collaborators at University of Washington who can make the materials. Here at PNNL, we can characterize and measure the formation of the materials. And we can combine our computational capabilities and we will make tremendous progress on understanding and predicting materials design.
When we look across the grand challenges society needs us to solve, like energy and water, we're going to be inventing new materials that really lower the cost and energy used to purify waters. It's a critical societal need. We're going to be creating quantum materials that are going to be the foundations of whole new technologies, everything from how we harvest energy and illuminate the world to new ways to do cybersecurity. When we look at energy materials, the batteries, the solar cells are all materials that harvest or transform energy. And this partnership between UW and PNNL is going to be accelerating that kind of progress.
Well, we believe our efforts put us on a pathway towards making materials by design. And that provides our two institutions, PNNL and University of Washington, with the opportunity to have broader impacts on society through transforming technologies for energy, water, and information.